So here you can see threat vulnerabilities and control and relation among them with a diagram. So you can see here this person, he's an attacker, he's the threat for the network. Okay, so he creates attacks. Now what happens, attacks exploits the vulnerability. That is the relation we understand from our previous discussion. Now vulnerability results in some impact. The impact means here it can be some data loss, some financial loss, and other kind of harassment, extortion, whatever it is, right? And what we can do to reduce the impact of an attack, okay? So we can do one thing, that is corrective control, okay, which decreases the impact. And on the other hand, if we don't want the attack itself, see this path, if I show only this path, then it means that there will be vulnerability exploitation. Due to that, there will be some impact and we can have some corrective control which will decrease the impact. But so this is one way. You allow the attackers to attack and you are trying to reduce the impact. But we can do another thing. We can have some deterrent control, which will reduces the likelihood of attacks. That means the deterrent controls are going to reduce the chances of attack to your network. This is one thing. Another thing you can do, that is detective control. That means you are detecting that there is some probability of attack due to this particular thing. Like, when you are allowing some traffic to your system, to your network, you are analyzing it. The traffic you are analyzing and trying to understand that whether this traffic can lead to some potential attack. If you are understanding that, okay, your analysis is saying you that, okay, it can lead to some attack, you can just not allow that traffic. Or on the other hand, it can be like that you are downloading some software. Before downloading or installing the software, you are just going through the security of the software, right? You are finding out that whether there is any loophole, there is any malicious thing reported about the software and all these things, okay? And then you are allowing it to install or not install, okay? So it discovers, so detective controls are basically discovers some attacks, and then you can just either stop the attack, and even if you don't stop the, if you can't stop the attack, then the attack can happen, but you can detect. Okay, now detective control detects, triggers. What it triggers? Preventive control. What is the preventive control? See, it protects the vulnerability. Okay, if you can detect that due to this traffic or this packet coming into my network can lead to some attack, you can trigger some preventive control, which can protect your vulnerability. And also, as you are going to know it beforehand that it is going to happen, you can also reduce the impact of the attack. Okay, so this is what we have discussed previously, and the relation among them are coming, okay, as an overall picture. All right, so let's move. So here you can see security threats are classified in different different classes, like human factors and natural factors are there. Natural factors are, you can understand, they are basically the physical things, and natural disaster happens like lightning, hurricane, tornado, tsunami, all these things. And on the other hand, human factors, which is very difficult to handle and difficult to detect and difficult to handle with it. You can't say that I will not have any human interaction with my systems. You have to have human interaction with your data, with your assets, with your systems. So this is a crucial thing, right? So human being can be your internal factor and it can be external threat. So most dangerous is internal factors, because human beings or users who are in the organization or who are already in your network, they are having some privilege to access the data. Okay, so if they are going to be, you know, disloyal to the organization or enterprise, so it is quite hard to tackle with. Okay, and again, there can be two type of people. One is former employees, like, you know, previously who was the employees, they left the enterprise, but they still have some credentials to access the data, and they also may know what is their security configuration, what are the vulnerabilities in the, you know, company, all these things. Okay, and current employees who are still in the company and can do it. So you can find numbers of time, you will find, previously we have seen reports that a bank employee, you know, stripped data from the bank of customers' data, they have thrift and they have sold it out outside. Okay, so that is what happens in real. Then external threats are basically human beings who are attackers trying to, you know, enter into your network through some loopholes and exploiting some vulnerabilities, right? So they can do some malicious events which can lead to, you know, some hackers or crackers, that they can also install some virus, trojan and worms on your systems or in your network. Okay, so this is the classification. Next, risk management team. So when we will be in a big organization, we will find that there is a risk management team and there is multiple teams who deals with different part of the security. First one is information system security. That means who looks over the system security, like the server, you know, the systems are desktop laptops used by the employees, all these things, you know, they maintenance. Then you will find some IT and operation management people who manages the IT operations, gives credentials, and who will access what and all these things. Then system and network administration, who maintains the network and systems physically, right? So where should be a network port, and how network you know, will be used, and subnets, and it will be divided into, you know, multiple subnet, and how people will be authenticated in the network, all these things they handle soon. Then internal audit, there will be another team who does audit of the log of network uses, of your server uses. So most of the servers are having their server log, and you can configure log for anything on the on a server. Okay, on a web server you can just configure a log for every person, you know, visiting your website. You can just maintain from where they are entering or accessing your website, from which IP address, through which route, okay, from which country, which location, everything you can save in the log. And what are the pages he have used? Does he uploaded something? Does the, you know, user downloaded something? Everything you can log. So by default, server does few things, but based on the requirement, you know, the security people can configure some extra, you know, additional data as per their requirement to log it out, and time to time, that logs need to be audited. Okay, so mainly we will find that the reports comes out that from this company some data was, you know, being thrift or leaked. All these things comes out when the log audit goes on. During the audit, they finds it out. Okay, then physical security. Physical security, I have already told you in previous discussion, like you know, how you are going to protect your systems and all physically from the physical you know, physical attacks, as well as the natural phenomena and all these things. Then business process and information owners, there will be, you know, another part of the system, that is the information owners, who are the actual owner of the information, they are also on team. Then human resources, the HR, then legal part, that means when you are collecting information of users, you need to be look into the legal part of it. Nowadays it is quite a hot topic, the legal part of different companies which are collecting information, like WhatsApp and some other companies. Okay, so there is big fight among almost in all the developed countries. They're quite concern, and they are also fighting with the companies. Like latest news I can tell you of a legality is that Twitter blocked the account of Donald Trump, right? So the Twitter is having its own lawyer who is looking into the legal part. People are shouting that it is against freedom of speech, but they are saying no, it is against the privacy policy and other policies of Twitter. So they are saying that it is violating. So and the enterprises needs legal people also, who are basically works with the security people, then physical safety of the things. So that is